hath no stomach to this fight. Let him depart. His passport shall be named, and grounds for convoy put into his purse. We would not die in that man's company that bears his fellowship to die with us. This day is called the Feast of Crispy. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand at tiptoe when this day is named, and rouse with the name of Crispy. He that shall see this day and live old age will yearly, on the vigil, feast his neighbors and say, tomorrow is St. Crispy. Then will he strip his sleeves and show his scars. He'll say, these wounds I had on Crispian Day. Old men forget that all shall be forgot, but who remember with advantages what feats he did that day? Then shall our names, familiar in their mouths as household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester, be in their flowing cups freshly remembered. This story shall a good man teach his son, and Crispian Crispian shall ne'er go by from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers, but he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother. Be he ne'er so vile, this day shall tender his condition. And gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves